I'm Eddie Muller, and trouble is my business. Today's trip through Noir Alley takes us far from the gates of major studios like Paramount and MGM and deep into a dodgy area known as Poverty Row. Today's film, made in 1948, is a product of Eagle Lion Films, a short-lived, low-budget studio that rose and fell during the heyday of film noir. It was responsible for several of the movement's most memorable and influential movies, T-Men, Raw Deal, Canyon City, He Walked by Night, and the film I have for you today, Hollow Triumph, also known in various re-releases as The Scar and The Man Who Murdered Himself. Eagle Lion was a British production company owned by movie mogul J. Arthur Rank. In 1947, it acquired Hollywood-based Producers Releasing Corporation, known as PRC, which jokers in the industry claimed was an acronym for pretty rotten crap. The plan was for Eagle Lion to make low-budget B films, each costing less than $500,000, to play the bottom half of double bills with A pictures imported from England. Brian Foy, who'd formerly commanded the B unit at Warner Brothers, was hired as Eagle Lion's production chief. Now, the strategy pioneered by the studio's boss, Arthur Krim, was to keep overhead low by working with independent producers who could marshal their own financing, an arrangement that attracted some of the sharpest producers in the business, guys like Edward Small, Aubrey Skenk, Jack Schwartz, and Walter Wanger. Well, another savvy businessman drawn to Eagle Lion was actor Paul Henreid. The Austrian emigre had enjoyed several years as a romantic leading man, most famously as Betty Davis's love interest in Now Voyager and freedom fighter Victor Laszlo in Casablanca, both released in 1942. By 1948, however, Henreid felt he was languishing at Warner Brothers, and he wanted to start working behind the camera. At the suggestion of Shekely István, a Hungarian who directed pictures under the Americanized name Steve Shekely, Henreid bought the rights to the novel Hollow Triumph by Murray Forbes. It was the sort of edgy, twisted crime yarn that was all the rage in Hollywood, and Henreid hired a terrific writer, Daniel Fuchs, to adapt the screenplay. Fuchs had written the dark and poetic script for the 1944 fantasy drama Between Two Worlds, in which Henreid co-starred with John Garfield, Eleanor Parker, and Sidney Greenstreet. Henreid chose his pal Shekely to direct the film, and he hired another Hungarian, the great John Alton, to photograph it in high noir style. The plot revolves around an on-the-lam crook named Johnny Muller. No relation. He eludes his pursuers by masquerading as a psychoanalyst, who, in a preposterous coincidence, is his identical twin, but for one distinguishing feature. There are more than a few such crazy coincidences in this story, but what holds the whole thing together is the character of the shrink's secretary, Evelyn Hahn, a hard-luck, chin-up working dame and one of my favorite characters in any film noir. Originally, Henreid wanted Evelyn Keyes for the part. They'd become friends during a highly publicized trip to Washington to protest the hearings of the House Committee on Un-American Activities, a trip organized by Keyes' husband, John Huston. Keyes, however, was under contract at Columbia and kept under the thumb of studio boss Harry Cohn. Before loaning out his star, Cohn demanded to read the script. He liked it so much, he tried to buy the project, with Henreid attached, and have the picture made at Columbia. But Henreid refused, knowing he'd be sacrificing control to King Cohn. Instead, he made the picture at Eagle Lion, where he had a much smaller budget, but all the control he wanted. He also scored a major coup when he convinced Joan Bennett to be his co-star. The actress had begun as an ingenue in the 1930s, a platinum-haired clone of Jean Harlow. But in the 40s, she remade herself as a smart-talking, sexy brunette, giving indelible and fatal performances in two Fritz Lang noirs, The Woman in the Window and Scarlet Street. She and her husband, producer Walter Wanger, formed Diana Productions with Fritz Lang to make films independent of the major studios. And as you'll see, Bennett could play much more than the slinky femme fatale. Here she creates a fully developed character, one that I'm sure resonated with a lot of single women in post-war America. And who knows, maybe with single women in contemporary America as well. From Eagle Lion Films and the emigre trio of Paul Henry, Steve Seckele, and John Alton, here is one of the bitterest little noirs of the classic era, Hollow Triumph.